All right, Jason Hettler here, and today we're going to discuss anaerobic speed reserve. This is a topic covered quite extensively in a recent podcast that I hosted with my good friend, Dr. Gareth Sandford. And so within this video, we'll try to set the stage for that discussion. We'll go over a couple of figures and charts from his PhD work. So what is anaerobic speed reserve? It's a range of two different speeds. At the top end, we have maximal sprint speed. Within the studies, this was tested using a 50-meter sprint test from a standing start, and it's primarily influenced by ground reaction force. On the bottom end of the range, we have velocity of VO2 max. This is the slowest speed at which maximal oxygen consumption is attained. So what benefit does this serve, and how does it apply within the middle distance realm? Anaerobic speed reserve offers a framework for assessing runner speed range relative to modern race day demands. Within the middle distances, there's been a greater need to be able to handle various surges and kicks throughout the race. So here we can see an athlete that is better set up for that than the other. Athlete A and B both have equivalent velocities at VO2 max, but athlete B has a greater maximal sprint speed. This means that they are better suited to handle the demands and the tactics that they will see within a race. Anaerobic speed reserve is only one piece of that puzzle, but we can start to identify what an athlete is capable of. Anaerobic speed reserve also allows us to gain a deeper insight into our individual athlete makeup. Here we are looking at some elite females, all with very similar 800 meter race times. But through the graph, we can start to understand where the intricacies lie, where their strengths and weaknesses may be. In the blue zone, we have velocity at 4 millimoles lactate. This can be thought of as equivalent to a half marathon pace. Green zone is a velocity of VO2 max, which is about a 2K pace, and then we have the maximal sprint speed in the red. So we can see, despite a very similar outcome from the three athletes, they do so with very different strengths and weaknesses. This provides one of the greatest insights from anaerobic speed reserve, in my opinion. It allows us to define an athlete's mechanical and neuromuscular ceiling within the middle distances. But I also think it's important to note that this type of information can be really worthwhile with team sport athletes as well. The more we can understand their makeup in a complex sport, any type of field sport really, we can have a better understanding of how to train them and what they're capable of. The three figures that we look at within this video come from the middle two research studies. I thought it was important to list a couple more of the research studies from Dr. Gareth Sandford, as he does a fantastic job of connecting the dots of anaerobic speed reserve. When embarking on his PhD, Gareth's aim was to answer two big questions. One, how much speed is enough? And two, how is it different between populations? I think not only does he do a fantastic job of uncovering the answers to these questions, he also highlights what anaerobic speed reserve is and is not, as well as many practical uses beyond middle distance. I urge anybody interested to dive further into the research and also give a listen to the recent podcast that I hosted with Dr. Gareth Sandford. Thank you.